What's up guys, welcome to the channel. In the last video, we talked about how despite the Tesla and SpaceX CEO Elon Musk achieved so much but is not in a good position with the current administration. Today in this video, we will talk about how desperate the Biden administration is against Tesla. I suggest you stick till the end of the video to not miss this interesting update. President Joe Biden is an ardent supporter of electric automobiles. His dedication to protecting the environment through zero-emission vehicles is undeniable. His views about Tesla, on the other hand, are in dispute. President Biden recently met with some of the biggest names in the electric vehicle sector, but Tesla was not invited, which is unusual. When asked to name the most prominent electric vehicle manufacturers, the answer is almost always Tesla, which is well deserved. Tesla is the electric vehicle poster boy, credited for making electric vehicles popular by appealing to people other than tech experts. The Roadster was the first electric supercar, and it pioneered the use of lithium-ion batteries in a production automobile, as well as pushing the limits of autonomous driving and enhancing battery performance. Despite being a relative newcomer, Tesla has done a lot for the electric vehicle market. Other EV startups are aiming to replicate the company's sales and manufacturing techniques due to its success. Tesla's EV technology is frequently hailed as being miles or years ahead of the competition. Musk always embraces competition because he feels it benefits humanity in the long term. Sandy Monroe, a famed auto industry observer, gushes about Tesla vehicles in terms of sheer quantity, but Tesla remains the undisputed leader. Since the launching of the Model 3, the business has topped global auto sales records. Examine Tesla's performance in the first half of this year in comparison to the competitors. According to data provided by Jose Pontes, Tesla produced the greatest number of battery electric automobiles than any other manufacturer. It sold 386,080 EVs, 140,000 more than the second placed company, Volkswagen, which sold 182,801. Tesla only manufactures EVs, yet Musk's company still comes out on top even when other manufacturers are permitted to include hybrids. Volkswagen is said to have sold 342,139 electric vehicles in total, approximately 40,000 fewer than Tesla. Stellantis, a conglomerate of well-known automakers, sold approximately 150,000 vehicles during the same time period. Tesla sold the most electric vehicles during this time period. Its Model 3 sold 243,753 units worldwide, followed by the very inexpensive Wuling Hongguang Mini EV built in China and another Tesla car, the Model Y, which sold 138,401 units. These figures make it appear weird that when President Joe Biden, a supporter of electric vehicles, met with the manufacturers of electric vehicles, he chose to exclude Tesla, the best performing manufacturer of electric automobiles. President Biden, on the other hand, summoned Stellantis, General Motors, and Ford. But that's not all. In the short period that Tesla has been in business, it has outpaced all traditional automakers in key criteria such as market capitalization, where it is far ahead of renowned brands like Toyota and Volkswagen. Tesla is frequently rated the highest in the automobile sector in terms of brand value. Despite never performing traditional advertising or employing a marketing team, its supercharger-branded network of fast chargers is ubiquitous. With over 25,000 outlets, it is placing electric vehicles on the map and putting it in everyone's face that they are here to stay. By delivering, Tesla even surpassed the competitors in GAAP profit. Tesla contributes significantly more to the American economy than its competitors. It has a plant in Fremont, California, and plans to open another in Texas. Teslas in the United States are manufactured at its Fremont plant, and the company sources more of its parts from local suppliers than any other EV manufacturer. According to a US government assessment, the Chevy Bolt, for example, imports almost 3/4 of its components from South Korea, including the pricey batteries. Ford manufactures the Mach-E crossover in Mexico and imports it into the United States. Tesla, on the other hand, derives 50 to 55% of its automotive components from American factories. Tesla is the only electric vehicle manufacturer who deserves to meet with President Biden. Musk was perplexed that his company had been overlooked, tweeting that he found it strange. Tesla, however, is not the only well-known EV manufacturer who has been passed over by the president. Volkswagen was excluded as well, despite having large sales and operating Electrify America, one of the country's most comprehensive public EV charging networks. So why did President Biden exclude Tesla, America's most famed American electric vehicle manufacturer, from his conference? You may argue that Tesla is so good at what it does that it doesn't require government assistance in any way. But that doesn't make any sense, because the president needs all the assistance he can get to make his clean energy targets. According to Tesla, it has aided the world's shift to sustainable energy by avoiding 5 million metric tons of carbon dioxide emissions in 2020. What the two most renowned EV companies had in common, and what the three makers who were invited have in common, is that all three vehicle makers, General Motors, Ford, and Stellantis, rely on the United Auto Workers Union. Tesla, like Volkswagen, does not use the UAW. The president's predilection for UAW automakers is unmistakable after a UAW union leader introduced him previously. The Biden administration's declaration encouraging more usage of EVs has been linked to the creation of well-paying union employment. When asked about Tesla's noteworthy absence from the briefing, White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki replied that the administration welcomes the efforts of automakers who understand the possibilities of an electric car future and supports efforts that will help the president attain his goal. She also agreed that Tesla is one of the firms, but tried to skirt the subject by suggesting that Tesla may be invited or participating in future discussions about electric vehicles. A dismissive reaction to a direct question about whether Tesla's non-union status was the reason it wasn't included, on the other hand, indicates a lot about President Biden's opinions about Tesla. Psaki responded, and I quote, "Well, these are the United Auto Workers, three major employers," unquote. During the briefing, the president stated that increasing EV sales requires purchasing incentives for consumers to buy clean vehicles built in the United States. For several years, the UAW attempted to unionize employees at Tesla's Fremont facility, but was unable to secure enough votes. The plant was a union facility while it was held jointly by Toyota and GM, but Tesla maintains the union left on its own even before the facility shuttered. Musk has always been anti-union, and he was sued for firing an employee who lobbied for it at the Fremont plant. His attitude toward the UAW is obvious in his response to a tweet about it. I quote, "Nothing is stopping the Tesla team at our car plant from voting union. Could do it tomorrow if they wanted to. But why would you pay union dues and give up stock options for nothing?" Unquote. He went on to list more reasons why his staff do not require a union. "Tesla already has a fantastic safety record, far better than when the plant was unionized. Workers already have higher healthcare benefits, and the job security generally guaranteed by unions did not occur during the recent recession." Musk stated that his tweet, which may have been seen as threatening to revoke stock options, would be carried out by the UAW at the conclusion of the press conference. the three government-appointed automakers made a unified statement stating their united goal of compromising 40 to 50% of their sales with electric vehicles, a goal that Tesla has more than met from day one. During the briefing, the president supported a request from two senators to prolong the $7,500 federal tax credit, which has been in existence for over a decade. Tesla is no longer eligible for this tax credit, but the proposal includes two new incentives, a $2,500 credit for automobiles built in America and a $2,500 credit for union-made vehicles, both of which exclude Tesla. That's all for this video. If you enjoyed the video, give a like, subscribe to the channel, and comment your opinions on how you think the snub by President Biden will affect Tesla. And don't forget to hit that notification bell to never miss a video.